Safety. I call to the Lord with my voice. supplication. I pour out my prayer before him, my concern before him, my trouble. When my spirit was overwhelmed with the need and pain of my past, in the path where I walked, they secretly lay a snare for me. I looked to the right and watched, but there was none to me. I have no refuge nor interior to my soul. I cried out to the Lord and said, who am I, hope in my fortune in the land of living? I kept my hands upon the water very low. Deliver me from the persecutors, for they are stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison and help me praise your name. Your righteous shall wait for me until you reward me. Out of the depths I have cried to you, O Lord, Lord, hear my voice.
Every male child among you shall be circumcised, and you shall be circumcised in the flesh of your foreskin. It shall be a sign of the covenant between me and you. A child of 8 days old shall be circumcised by you, every male child throughout your genealogy. And the uncircumcised male child who is not circumcised in the flesh of his foreskin on the 8th day, that soul shall be cut off from his people, for he has broken my covenant.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Proverbs.
Let us be attentive.
The Lord created me in the beginning of his ways for his works. He established me in the beginning before time, before he made the earth, and before he made the abysses, before the going forth of the fountains of waters. Before the mountains were created, and he begot me before all hills. The Lord made the fields and the uninhabited places and the inhabited heights under heaven. When he prepared heaven, I was present with him, and when he set apart his throne upon the winds. when he made strong the things above the clouds and made sure the foundations under heaven and made strong the foundations of the earth that was working beside him. I was he in whom he rejoiced. Daily and continually I was gladdened by his face.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Proverbs.
Let us be attentive.
The mouth of a righteous man distills wisdom. The lips of righteous men distill grace. The mouth of the humble meditates on wisdom. The righteousness of upright men delivers them. When a righteous man dies, his hope does not perish. A righteous son is begotten unto life. A good man eats from the fruits of righteousness. Light is with the righteous continually, and they will find grace and glory from the Lord. The tongue of the wise understands good things. There is wisdom in the good heart of a man. The Lord loves holy hearts, and all the blameless are acceptable to him. Wisdom is radiant and unfading. She comes upon those who know, who long to know her beforehand, and is easily perceived by those who love her. He who rises early in the morning to seek her will not grow weary, and he who keeps watch for her will soon be free from worry. Because she goes about seeking those worthy of her, and she appears to them favorably in their paths. Evil cannot overcome wisdom. I became a lover of her beauty. I loved her and sought her from my youth, and desired to take her as a bride for myself. The master of all loves her, for she is an initiate of the knowledge of God and one who chooses his works. The products of righteousness are the virtues, for wisdom teaches self-control, discernment, righteousness, and courage, concerning which things there is nothing more valuable in the life of man. But also, if anyone longs for great experience, she knows the things of old and portrays the things to come. She understands subtlety of words and the solution of riddles. She has foreknowledge of signs and wonders and the outcomes of times and seasons. And to all she is a good counselor. In kin with wisdom there is immortality, and in the fellowship of her words there is good repute. So I entreated the Lord and besought him, and with all my heart I said, O God of our fathers, and the Lord of mercy, who made all things by your word, and in your wisdom built a man, that by you he might be the master of what is created, and manage the world in holiness and righteousness, give me the wisdom that sits by your throne, and do not reject me from among your servants, because I am your servant and the son of your maidservant. Send her forth from your holy heavens, and send her from your glorious throne, that she might be present with me in labor, and that I might know what is well-pleasing to you. For she knows and understands all things, and she will guide me wisely in my actions and guard me with her glory. For the reasoning of mortals is cowardly, and our intents are unsafe.
Let us lay our in prayer unto the
Lord.
O Lord, almighty God of our fathers, we pray you hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy upon us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray thee hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for our metropolitan Beatitude, God, our Archbishop's Eminence, Nathaniel, and for all our brethren in Christ. This country, its president, also authorities in the armed forces everywhere. Again, we pray for our august mother, Christopher, and the sister of this holy monastery for their health and salvation. And we pray for the blessed and ever member Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever member founders of this holy monastery, for the newly departed servants of God, King Michael, Archpriest John, Anna, Angel, Mary, Rose, Charles, Gabriel, Charlene, Anne, Christopher, Helen, Agnes, Julia, Philip, Shirley, Helen, Jamie, Soren, Gerald, Jean, Mary, Benjamin, Bonnie, Monica, Irene, and for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox departed this life before us, who here and in all the world lie asleep, in the Lord. Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, the sister of this holy monastery, and for the faithful gathered here, and for the servants of God, Archpriest John, Archpriest Constantine, Archpriest Paul, Archpriest Michael, Priest Lawrence, David, Abbess Tecla, the child Sophia, Nathaniel, the child Cole, the infant Easton, the infant Penelope, the child Preston, Fred, Stephen, Melinda, Coria, Barbara, Matusha. Patricia, Priscilla, Stacy, Joanna, Meredith, Anthony, Patricia, Hoda, Tracy, Leonard, Susan, Debbie, Genevieve, Helen, Emily, Kirikos, Helen, Anthony, Amanda, Olga, Michael, Andreas, Vasily, Noah, Brittany, and Vasiliki, and for the pardon and remission of their sins. And we pray for those who bring offerings and do the works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, and for all the people who are present who await thy great and rich mercy.
Thank you.
theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, and Cyril of Alexandria, Ignatius of Antioch, Polycarp of Smyrna, Irenaeus of Lyon, and Cyprian of Carthage, of our fathers among the saints, Nicholas of Myra and Lycia, the wonder worker, Leo and Gregory of Rome, Ambrose of Milan, and the holy confessor Patrick of Ireland, of the holy Nina and Nightmare of Georgia, the holy Methodius and Cyril, the teachers of the Slavic people, the holy great prince Vladimir, the blessed princess Olga, and Nicholas equal to the apostles and enlightener of Japan, of our fathers among the saints, the hierarchs of all Rus, Peter, Alexis, Cyprian, Jonah, Macarius, Philip, Job, and Hermogenes, of our fathers among the saints, Clement of Opus, Saba of Serbia, and Euthemius of Trinovo, Innocent, Paul of Moscow, enlightener of the Alliance, the holy confessor, Deacon, Patriarch of Moscow, enlightener of North America, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, Nikolai of Zicha, who labored in America, and John, the wonderworker, Archbishop of Shanghai and San Francisco, of the holy, glorious, and right, victorious martyrs, the holy proto-martyr and archdeacon Stephen, the great martyr, and healer Pantaleon, the great martyrs, Demetrius, the mercenary, and George, the trophy bearer, of the holy proto-martyr among women, Thecla, and of the holy great martyrs, Catherine, Barba, Aristeva, of Alban, the proto-martyr of Britain, and Cosmas, of Aegelia, of Juvenali, the proto-martyr of America, and his companion Peter, the Aleut, martyr of California, and the hero martyrs John, Alexander, Seraphim, and Vasily, who labored in America, and all the holy martyrs and confessors of Russia, of our venerable and God-married fathers and mothers, Anthony of Egypt, Savas, the sanctified, Mary of Egypt, and Pelagia, the penitent, Anthony and Theodosius, and the other wonder workers of the caves, Monastery, Sergius of Radonezh, Job of Pachag, Seraphim of Sarah, Pais of Elikovsky, Nicodemus, and Siloam of the Holy Mountain, Herman the Wonder Worker of Alaska and all America, of the Holy and Righteous Priest, Alexis of Wilkesboro, Jacob of Alaska, and John of Kronstadt, the Wonder Worker, and the Holy and Righteous, Julian the Merciful of Lazarigo, of the Holy Blessed Sinya of St. Peterburg, and Matrona of Moscow, of the Holy St. Basil, the Great Archbishop of Caesarea, whose memory we keep this day, of the Holy and Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, we beseech you, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto us sinners, who make our supplication unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Yeah.
pardon our sins and have mercy upon us. For thou art a merciful God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
our sins. Mass upon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
10th. I lay down and slept, I hope for the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people who have set themselves against me round about. Arise, O Lord, save me, O my God, for you have struck on the cheek all without cause of my enemies. You have broken the teeth of sinners. Salvation is of the Lord, your blessing is upon your people. I lay down and slept, I hope for the Lord will help me. O Lord, rebuke me not in your wrath, nor chasten me in your anger. For your arrows have pierced me, and you have laid your hand heavily upon me. There is no health in my flesh because of your wrath, nor is there any rest in my bones because of my sins. For my iniquities have gone over my head like a weighty burden, they have heavy upon me. My wounds are foul and festering because of my foolishness. I suffered and was utterly bowed down all day long and walked in sadness. For my loins are filled with burning, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I have been afflicted and humbled beyond measure. I cried out because of the affliction of my heart. O Lord, all my desire is before you, and my sighing is not hidden from you. My heart is troubled, my strength fails me, and the light of my eyes is also gone from me. My friends and neighbors drew near to me and stood silently, and my kinsmen stood afar off. Those who sought after my soul used violence. Those who sought my ruin spoke vain things and imagined deceits all the day long. But I, like a deaf man, did not hear, like a dumb man who does not open his lips. I became like a man who does not hear and does not think of reproofs. For in you, O Lord, I have hoped, will hear me, O Lord my God. I said, let not my enemies rejoice over me. For when my foot slipped, they boasted against me. For I am ready for wounds, my affliction is continually before me. For I will confess my iniquity, and my soul is afflicted because of my sins. But my enemies live and are mightier than I am. Those who hate me without cause are multiplied. Those who render me evil for good slander me because I followed after good. Do not forsake me, O Lord my God, do not depart from me. I said to my help, O Lord, and my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord my God, do not depart from me. Attend to my help, O Lord, and my salvation. O God, my God, early in the morning I turn to you. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord, my flesh longs for you. As in a trackless desert land where no water is. So I appear before you in the sanctuary to see your power and glory. Because your mercy is better than life, my lips will praise you. Thus I will bless you while I live, I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul will be filled with oil and fat, and my mouth will praise you with joyful lips. I remember you upon my bed and meditate on you in the morning, for you are my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul is pleased with you, your right hand upholds me. But those who sought my life in vain, they shall be delivered up to the sword, they shall be a portion for foxes. But their king shall rejoice in God, and everyone who swears by him shall be praised. But the mouth of those who speak unrighteousness shall be stopped. I meditate on you in the morning, for you are my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul is pleased to you, your right hand upholds me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, I have cried out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you, incline your ear to my supplication. For my soul is full of troubles, and my life drives me to hell. I am counted with those who go down to the pit. I have become like a man without help, free among the dead. Like the slain who lie in the grave, whom you remember no more, and who are cut off from your hand. You have laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness and in the shadow of death. Your wrath lies heavy upon me, and you have afflicted me with all your ways. You have put away my acquaintance as far from me, they regard me with horror. I was delivered up and have not come forth, my eyes weakened from weeping. Lord, I have called daily upon you, I have stretched out my hands to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? Will the shades rise up and praise you? Who will tell of your mercy in the grave or your righteousness in the place of destruction? Will your wonders be known in the darkness and your truth in the land of forgetfulness? But to you I have cried out, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer comes before you. O Lord, why do you cast off my soul? Why do you turn away your face from me? I am poor and in distress from my youth. I was exalted, then I was humiliated and brought very low. Your wrath passed over me. Your terrors troubled me like water. They engulfed me all the day long and overwhelmed me. You have put far away from you my friends, my neighbors, and my acquaintances because of my sufferings. O Lord God of my salvation, I have cried out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you, incline your ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord of my soul and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from corruption, who crowns you with mercy and compassion, who satisfies your desire with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works deeds of mercy and executes justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his will to the children of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and abundant in mercy. He will not always be angry, nor leave you at enmity with us forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, the Lord has confirmed his mercy on those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our transgression from us. As the Father has compassion on his children, so the Lord is compassionate to those who fear him. For he knows whereof we are made, he remembers that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass, like a flower of the field, so he blossoms. For when the wind passes over it, it is gone, and his place remembers it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is an everlasting, everlasting on those who fear him. And his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord has prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty and strange, to do his word, even the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all his hosts and ministers, who do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. In all places of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. Hear my prayer, O Lord, give ear to my supplication, your faithfulness, hear me in your righteousness. And do not be judged with your servant, for in your sight, O my living shall be justified. For the enemy has persecuted my soul, he has humbled my life to the ground, he has made me to dwell in darkness, and those who have long been dead. Therefore my spirit is overwhelmed within me, my heart within me is troubled, and I remember the days of old, I meditated on all your works. I mused on the works of your hands, I spread out my hands to you, my soul longed for you like a thirsty land. Hear me speedily, O Lord, my spirit fails. Turn not your face from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. Make me hear your mercy in the morning, for in you I have hope. Make me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. Your name, seek, O Lord, enliven me in your righteousness. Hear my soul about a tribulation, your mercy cut off my enemies. And destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, and do not in judgment with your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, and do not in judgment with your servant. Your good spirit shall lead you in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God.
Give peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Himself to us. Blessed is he that comes.
an inexhaustible treasury of teachings by which he taught us to worship the Holy Trinity, united in essence, but separate in persons. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. All-wise Basil, as you stand before the Trinity, pray that on the day of judgment, we who sing hymns to you and honor your memory may receive grace, mercy, and cleansing of transgressions, and may glorify the one who alone is the lover of mankind, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. The Creator of all and the Master of the world, while being on high with the Father and the Spirit, is circumcised on earth as an eight-day-old child. Your works are indeed divine and wonderful, for you, O Master, as the fulfillment of the law, were circumcised for our sake. You drew forth divinely the hidden riches of ineffable wisdom. Basil, you have poured out on all the waters of the Orthodox faith, which divinely rejoice the hearts of the faithful, drowning the commands of the faithless. Therefore, you have been doubly revealed as an invincible champion of the Trinity. By the sweat of your works of faithfulness, holy Bishop Basil, entreat Christ God that he grant remission of sins to those who celebrate your holy memory with love. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Like water you have given the whole world to drink of your teachings, the collected dogmas of piety, for the wellspring of life truly lived within you, O Basil, since you have gained boldness before him, divinely inspired one, beseech him to grant us great mercy. Now and ever and unto ages of ages, amen. The one who is invisible in essence has now become visible in the flesh. The uncreated word takes now form, born of the pure virgin. Therefore, following the law for our sake, he is circumcised as an eight-day-old child. Let us worship him as our God and Savior.
Praise the name of the Lord. Give praise, all servants of the Lord. Alleluia. Hear the sending in the house of the Lord. In the courts of the house of our God. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing to his name, for he is gracious. Alleluia. For I know that the Lord is great, and that our Lord is above all gods. Alleluia. Whatever the Lord pleases, he does. In heaven, in the earth, in the sea, and all deep. Alleluia. Blessed be the Lord from Zion. He who dwells in Jerusalem. Alleluia. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia. Alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia. O give thanks to the Father of God. For his mercy endureth forever.
Mercy endureth forever.
Oh!
the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Set at naught all the reasonings of Nestorius, the holy hierarch Basil, entreat Christ God that he may grant remission of transgressions unto those who with love celebrate your holy memory. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The grace of your divine discourses and the mystic heights of your dogmas have become for us a ladder of divine ascent, for having acquired the clarion of the Spirit, O Father, you thereby proclaim divine doctrines, wherefore you have made your abode in the place of your order, receiving the reward of your struggles. O venerable hierarch Basil, entreat Christ God that he grant remission of transgressions unto those who with love celebrate your holy memory, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. The master and creator of all, who received flesh from you all to our womb, has shown to you to be an intercessor for men, O most immaculate one. Wherefore, we all flee to you, asking to be cleansed of our transgressions, O mistress, and to be delivered from everlasting torments and all the oppression of the evil prince of this world. For this cause, we cry unto you, entreat your Son and God that he grant remission of transgression unto those who with faith worship your most holy birth-giving.
From my youth to many passions war against me, but you, O my Savior, defend and save me. You haters of Zion shall be shamed by the Lord, for like grass by the fire shall you be withered. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Through the Holy Spirit every soul is vivified, and my cleansing is exalted, and enlightened by the Trinity through a mystical sanctification. Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. From the Holy Spirit,
right.
he will be saved, and will go in and out and find pasture. The thief does not come except to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I have come that they may have life, and that they may have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep, but a hireling, he who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming, and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf catches the sheep and scatters them. The hireling flees because he is a hireling and does not care about the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep and am known by my own. As the Father knows me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And other sheep I have which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock and one shepherd.
Șterge fără de legea mea, mai vârtos mă spală de fără de legea mea și de păcatul meu mă curățește. Că fără de legea mea eu cunosc, păcatul meu înaintea mea este pururea. Ție unui am greșit și rău înaintea ta am făcut, așa că îndreptești tu într-o cuvintele tale și biruitor când vei judeca tu. Căci iată că fără de legi m-a zămislit și în păcate m-a născut Maica mea. Căci iată adevărul a iubit, cele nearătate și le ascunse ale înțelepciunii tale mi-a arătat mie. Stropi-mă vei cu isop și mă voi curăți, spăla-mă vei și mai vârtos decât zăpada mă voi albi. Auzului meu vei da bucurie și veselie, bucuroase vorboasele mele cele smerite. Întoarce fața ta de la păcatele mele și toate fără de legile mele ștergele. Inima curată zidește într-un mine Dumnezeule și Duh drept înnoiește într-un cele din omul ale mele. Nu mă lepăda de la fața ta și Duhul tău cel Sfânt nu la de la mine. Dă-mi mie bucuria mântuirii tale și cu Duh stăpânitor mă întărește. Învăța voi pe cei fără de lege căile tale și cei necredincioși la tine să mă întoarce. Izbăvește-mă de vărsarea de sânge, Dumnezeule, Dumnezeul mântuirii mele. Bucuroasă va limba mea de dreptate ta. Doamne, buzele mele vei deschide și gura mea va vesti lauda ta. Că de-ai fi voi jertfă ți-aș fi dat, ardele de tot nu le vei binevoi. Jertfa lui Dumnezeu, Duhul umilit, inima înfrântă și smerită Dumnezeu nu va ocesi. Fă bine, Doamne, cu bunăvoirea ta Sionului și să se zidească zidurile Ierusalimului. Atunci vei binevoi jertfa dreptății prin osă și ardele de tot. Atunci vor pune pe altarul tău viței.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Through the prayers of the holy saints, the sacred bishop, the merciful one, blood of the multitude of our transgressions, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Through the prayers of the Theotokos, O merciful one, multitude of our transgressions. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great goodness, and according to thy abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Father, grace was shed from your lips, and you are a shepherd of the church of Christ. Tend these sheep of a rational nature, that they might believe in the consubstantial Trinity, in one Godhead.
O God, save thy people and bless thy inheritance. Visit thy world with mercy and compassion. Exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians and send out upon us thy rich mercies, through the intercessions of our all-pure Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, by the might, the precious and life-giving cross, through the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and baptizer John, of the holy, glorious, and all-honorable apostles of our fathers among the saints, the great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the great, Gregory the theologian, and John Chrysostom, of our father among the saints, Nicholas the Wonderworker, Archbishop of Myra and Lycia, of our fathers among the saints, Innocent Metropolitan of Moscow, Enlightener of the Aleuts, the Holy Confessor Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Enlightener of North America, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn,
Nikolai of Zicha, who labored in America, and John the Water Worker, Archbishop of Shanghai and San Francisco, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyr Juvenali, the proto-martyr of America, and his companion, and the hero martyrs John and Alexander, of the holy, glorious, great martyr George, the trophy bearer, of the holy, great martyr, and the hero gentle layman of the holy, great martyr Barbara, of the holy martyr Peter the Aleut, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone forth in the ascetic lives, Seraphim of Sarah, Herman the Wonder Worker of Alaska and all America, of the holy and righteous priest, Jacob, enlightener of the native people of Alaska, Alexis of Wilkesboro in Minneapolis, of the holy Saint Basil the Great, whose memory we keep this day, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of all the saints, we beseech you, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto us sinners who make our supplication unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Omnibile Yashe,
guiding the people he led out from bondage to the Egyptians, who gloriously has he been glorified. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Bearing a symbol of things to come, the eighth day is sanctified and brightened by thy voluntary poverty, O Christ. For on this day thou wast circumcised in the flesh according to the law. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Christ accepts the circumcision of the eighth day after his birth, and on that day the prefiguring shadow is clothed by the light of the dawning new grace.
Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us, the Son, that your voice will be welcome company for those desiring to prepare praises in your honor, but in its place grant them the indulgence of abundant grace. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You tamed the play of the passions and torments of the flesh by your love for the pursuit of wisdom. Therefore, O Father Basil, you dwell in the unassailable kingdoms. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You trod the thorny path of virtues to reach the plain and peaceful way up to heaven. And so were revealed as a pattern for all men, O Basil. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. With the sword of the Spirit, O Basil, you wisely cut down the passions both of soul and body, and offer yourself as a sacrifice to the Master. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You befriended ineffable things, O Basil, initiating men into the kingdom of Christ, O Holy Father, causing the light of the Trinity to shine clearly on us, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Who can rightly tell of your ineffable conceiving? For you bore God in the flesh, the Savior of all who appeared to us, O merciful new Virgin.
O Lord, uncover the floor of the deep, and on the dry ground he drew his feet.
Saving to be circumcised on the eighth day.
Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You manifestly trampled down the things of the earth with the fullness of all teaching, O Basil, and the light of a better world. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. For the love of the better part, you flew on wings of wisdom, O Basil, taught in the fear of the Lord, the beginning of wisdom. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You wisely ascended by action, O Basil, showing deeds to be the way to the most divine contemplation, learning well the knowledge of future things, now and ever in the two ages and ages. Amen. O pure and ever virgin, you conceived God in your womb without seed, and ineffably brought him forth upon whom the hosts of heaven spare not days.
Revealed, flashing forth from you with lightning, O Theotokos.
Venerable Father Basil, Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. Today the Church worthily honors a twofold feast, the feast of the circumcision of the Master as a child who appeared on earth, and the memorial of his wise and thrice blessed servant. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. The incomprehensible light ever rested in you, O Saint, for Christ is manifested you as a radiant light to the world. Therefore we praise your memory, O Basil. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. Moses, the lawgiver, and Joseph, who before the law distributed corn for food, were not equal to you, O Basil, for you were manifested as a celebrant at the breaking of the divine flesh at the altar. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. What was present on Sinai and shown to Moses as in a dim mirror, you made plain to all men, O Basil. Now and ever and unto ages of ages, amen. We cry out to you who bore Christ the Creator. Rejoice, O pure one, for you have made the light to rise for us. Rejoice, for you have encompassed the uncircumscribed God.
Jesus, the source of my life, came to free from condemnation Adam the first mortal. As God, he needs no cleansing, yet from the fallen he is cleansed in the joy.
But, O Lord, lead my life up out of corruption, as thou didst lead up Jonah. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. The law became of no effect when Christ became a child, and was manifest as the fulfillment of the law. By accepting circumcision, he has set us free from the curse. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Through the Spirit, Christ, by appearing, has caused the Sabbath and circumcision of the haughty Jews to cease, and the spring of grace has shone.
Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You bountifully fed the souls of the poor, wasted with hunger, O Basil, filling their famished hearts with every divine gladness. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You fed the souls of the hungry with heavenly food, for your word, O Basil, is the bread of angels, and you were a generous dispenser of grain. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. With love of labor, O Basil, you gathered every virtue as bees from the flowers. Becoming all wise, you were called blessed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You made haste to break the bonds of the world in order to live with God. Therefore, laying aside unstable and corruptible things, you wisely gained those that are eternal. Now and ever and unto ages of ages, amen. O unwedded Theotokos Mary, the bush on Sinai transfigured with fire, portrayed you, O ever virgin mother. By the pure spirit of his life, his faith, his fervor, and his humility. Through these he was manifested as the dwelling of God. Crying aloud to him, we sing, O Basil, our venerable and heavenly Father.
The three children trampled on the ungodly command to adore the golden calf of the Persian field, and sprinkled with dew, they sang in the midst of the fire, Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Today, the bright and shining birth of Christ and the mystery of the coming rebirth are portrayed. For the Savior is circumcised according to the decree of the law, not as God, but as mortal man, yet the fulfiller of the law. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Today, the maker of the law is voluntarily circumcised, thus fulfilling it and circumcising our sins, causing us to cry, Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers.
Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. The Son has appeared as an image of the Father, and the Spirit as an image of the Son. And you, O Basil, are a clear glass and a dwelling of the Trinity. Your memory is blessed, and those who glorify it shall themselves be glorified. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You plunged your mind into the depth of the incomprehensible things of God, and collecting the most precious pearl of knowledge, you enriched the world with wisdom, teaching it to cry, Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. You both were as one soul in two bodies, Gregory in Basil and Basil in Gregory, united by divine love. Pray now to Christ for your flock. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. Father of orphans and champion of widows, wealth for the poor and comfort for the weak, you have shown, O Basil, to be a guide for the wealthy, a staff for the old, and a teacher of virtue for the young who live the monastic life. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You cleansed your mind of filthy defilement, and in the Spirit you longed for, you searched out the things of the Spirit. Therefore, singing the praises of the Trinity, you cried out with boldness, Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Moses foresaw you on Mount Sinai as pure as the burning bush, receiving unconsumed the unbearable brightness of the ineffable one who was united in you as one of the holy persons to the flesh of man.
My Lord is sent of an angel of God and by the whistling wind of dew, the holy youths walk in the fiery furnace free from war, refreshed with dew in the flames and thanksgiving they sang, you are blessed and highly exalted, O Lord God of our fathers.
All works of the Lord bless the Lord. The word of God has ordered all things in his wisdom, leading them from nothingness into being. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. The Master was circumcised on the eighth day, and he received the name of Jesus, for he is the Savior and the Lord of all the world. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. The most glorious memorial of the bishop is joined to the feast of the Nativity of Christ. Honoring both the feasts, we sing the praises of the Lord.
Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. Basil, the light of godliness and trumpet of theology, has been given to the world in an ineffable dispensation. All works of the Lord, bless the Lord. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. The generous and active power dwelt in the wise Basil, and he discoursed with reverence on the nature of God. All works of the Lord, bless the Lord. Holy Hierarch Basil, pray to God for us. Ever delighting in your divine words and praising your memory, we cry, O Basil, all works of the Lord, bless the Lord. Let us bless the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Enlightening the world with the radiance of your words, O Basil, you guided it with light to worship the one nature of the Trinity. All works of the Lord, bless the Lord, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. All works of the Lord, bless the Word, pre eternal and timeless, proceeding from the Father, and in these latter days arising from the Virgin. We praise, we bless, we worship the Lord, singing and exalting him throughout all ages.
When the furnace in Babylon warred for dew, it foreshadowed a marvelous mystery. The Jordan accepted the immaterial fire into its streams and encompassed the Creator when he was baptized in the flesh. Him the peoples bless and highly exalt forever.
the limits of man's entire nature. He was born beyond nature, a virgin. And he who clearly directs the letter of the law is circumcised in the flesh and shown to be the fulfillment of the law.
Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all your stars and light.
Praise in you heaven of heavens, and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he spoke, and they came to be, commanded, and they were created. He established them forever, yea, forever and ever. He has made a decree which shall not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, through dragons and all deeps, fire, hail, snow, and frost, stormy wind, fulfilling his word. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, creeping things and feathered birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all judges of the earth, young men and maidens, old men and children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted, his glory is on earth and in heaven, and he has exalted the horn of his people. All his saints will praise him, even the children of Israel, the people near to him. Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise in the congregation of the saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him, let the sons of Zion rejoice in their king. Let them praise his name with the dance, let them sing praises to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people, he will exalt the meek and save them. Let the saints be exalted in glory, they will rejoice in their midst. The praises of God shall be in their mouths, and two-edged swords in their hands, to execute vengeance on the nations and chastisement on the people, to bind their kings with fetters and their nobles with chains of iron, to execute on them the judgment that is written, such as the glory of all his saints.
You who without separation and corruption was born ineffably of the Word, as the Word of the Father, God from God, in the changeless Godhead undergoes circumcision in the flesh. He who is above the law delivers all from the curse of the law by becoming himself under the law and granting us the blessing from on high. Therefore, praising his infinitely gracious condescension, we sing his praises and we glorify him with thanksgiving, entreating him that our souls may be saved.
Praise God, the saints, praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for...
of divine wisdom.
without separation and corruption was born ineffably as the word of the Father, God from God, and the changeless God had undergo circumcision in the flesh. He was above the law, delivers all from the curse of the law by becoming himself under the law and granting us the blessing from on high. Therefore, praising his infinitely great condescension, we sing his praises and glorify him with thanksgiving, entreating him that our souls be saved. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Grace poured forth from your lips, O Father, you were a shepherd in Christ's church, tending reasonable sheep, bringing them to the faith in the consubstantial Trinity and essential unity, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Oh, Lord God.
every goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for Metropolitan Gander T. Connor, Archbishop His Eminence Nathaniel, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for this country, its president, also authorities in the armed forces everywhere.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for our Abbess Mother Christophora and the sisters of this holy monastery for their health and salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for the blessed and ever memorable holy Orthodox patriarchs, for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy monastery, for the departed servants of God, King Michael, Archpriest John, Anna, Angel Mary, Rose, Charles, Gabriel, Charlene, Anne, Christopher, Helen, Agnes, Julia, Philip, Shirley, Helen, Jamie, Soren, Gerald, Jean, and Mary, and for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox departed this life before us, and here and in all the world lie asleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, the sister of this holy monastery, and for the faithful gathered here, and for the servants of God, Archpriest John, Archpriest Constantine, Archpriest Paul, Archpriest Michael, Priest Lawrence, Deacon David, Abbess Thecla, the child Sophia, Nathaniel, the child Cole, the infant Easton, the infant Penelope, Fred, Stephen, Melinda, Corey, Barbara, Matushka, Priscilla, Stacy, Joanna, Meredith, Anthony, Patricia, Hoda, Tracy, Leonard, Susan, Debbie, Genevieve, Helen, Emily, Tiricos, Helen, Anthony, Amanda, Olga, Michael, Andreas, Vasily, Noah, Brittany, and Vasiliki, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, God. Now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom.
Honor in the blessing.
Blessed be he who is Christ our God always, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Preserve, O Lord God, the holy and pure faith of pious and Orthodox Christians, with this holy monastery in this countryside, to the ages of ages. Amen.
Most holy Virgin, help us save us.
More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, who without loss of virginity gave birth to God the Word, true birth giver of God, we praise you.
Glory to thee, O Christ, for God and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
Making you on the eighth day to be circumcised in the flesh for our salvation, Christ our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, by the protection of the honorable bodies and powers of heaven, through the prayers of the holy, glorious, and all honorable apostles, of the holy Saint Basil, the great Archbishop of Caesarea and Cappadocia, whose memory we keep this day, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind.
Congregation, sing a Christmas carol for us in Romanian, a Christmas carol in Greek, and whatever else you can do. We're done singing, but your turn is now. We'll come forward and venerate the holy icons, and then in a few minutes the dinner will be ready in the dining room. Cesar, begin.
I'm not prepared.
Well, Christmas was just a day ago.
Bring my books.
I'm
going to
words here.
Hold on just a second.
One of these. Greeks, if you can beat the Romanians, here you have
Well, you've got some friends, some Romanian friends back there. Come on.
Thank you.
languages.
Hard not to do a dance.